I am here to give you my April TBR. So I'm doing a read-a-thon this month, so I have 4 books right here that I'm going to try to read for the read-a-thon, which will take place from April 1st to April 30th. And the first book on my list is Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde. One of the requirements is a book that's shorter than 150 pages. This book is... Hold on a sec. This book is 124 pages, so I could definitely get through this very quickly. Then the next book on here is MacBeth, which is based... it's in my Nook, so I'm showing off my Nook. And MacBeth is basically a book that starts with M. So, MacBeth. Then the next book on my list is a book with a white cover, and I have my Our Chemical Hearts by Krystal Sutherland, which I don't know much about, but it is a book with a white cover. Then the fourth book for the readathon is The Last Kingdom by Bernard Cornwell, and it is a historical book. I don't usually gravitate towards historical novels, so I'm going to give this one a try. Then the next book on my list is Once and For All by Sarah Dessen, and I just saw it on my TBR on Goodreads. I haven't read it yet, and it's been on my TBR for years at this point. So, Once and For All. Then next on my list is The World's Best Fairy Tales, a Reader's Digest Anthology, which is basically a bunch of different stories about the Snow Queen, the Ugly Duckling, Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs, and it even has illustrations in here. I'll just try to find something for you really quickly. The Tinderbox, and then we just have this older lady right here. This book has been on my shelf for many, many years, and I think my mom owned it, and this was her book. She read the stories to me when I was a child, but I want to give them a shot for myself in my adult years. So we got the World's Best Fairy Tales. And then the next book after that is The Toll, which is the third and final installment in the Thunderhead, the Scythe series? Yes, the Scythe series. And this is a hefty little guy, or should I say big fella. I'm excited to delve into this story and figure out where it goes. Like, book two had me guessing, or like, had me going, ha? What? But, The Toll. After The Toll, I want to pick up It Ends With Us by Collen Hoover. I'm trying to read 20 romance books this year. I'm at 4 already, which is great. And I picked this up last year. I still haven't read it yet, so it's on my TBR, of course. After that, it is Parental Guidance, another romance novel for my goal. So, I don't know much about it. I think it's like an ice hockey love story or something like that. So, there's that. The Beautiful, which is basically a vampire-esque story set in New Orleans. I've been to New Orleans, so I kind of can't wait to read how this is... how the story plays out. So I have The Beautiful. Then after that, I have Ninth House by Leigh Bardugo, which is basically a secret society. I don't know much about it, but I can't wait to delve into it. Then I have The Black Prism by Brent Weeks, which has been strongly and highly recommended to me. Then after that, I have The Obelisk Gates, which is the second book in the Broken Earth trilogy by N.K. Jemisin, which I cannot wait to get into. I love this series already, so highly recommend it. Then also by N.K. Jemisin, The City We Become is another book on my list to read. Then after that, A Heart So Fierce and Broken, which is the sequel to, what is it? I will show you the book that it's the sequel to, so I'll put that up there. Then the next book on my list is Mage's Blood, which is part of the Moontide Quartet. I think it deals with sirens or something. So I will see where this goes as well. Then after that, A Night of Cake and Puppets, which is the book in between book 2 and book 3, which is Days of Blood and Starlight and God's Dreams of Gods and Monsters is the book that takes place in between these two. So these are also on my TBR as well. I started it a little bit today, so I guess it technically doesn't count for April, but since I'm going to be finishing this book in April, hopefully, so it's going to count as April. But these are the two final books in the Daughter of Smoke and Bone trilogy, which is Days of Blood and Starlight and Dreams of Gods and Monsters. Then I want to read Watchmen by Alan Moore and Dave Gibbons. This is a graphic novel, a compilation of the whole series. I watched the movie years ago and I read this before, but it's been 10 years. I've forgotten stuff, so I want to re-delve into the story, and I kind of want to watch it on HBO. Yeah, it's on HBO. I kind of want to watch it on HBO or re-watch the movie again. Then after that, I want to read The Final Empire, or better known as Mistborn, because it's the first book in the Mistborn series. It's always a they always think that it's actually Mistborn, but it's actually The Final Empire, so I want to read this as well. Then after that, I want to read The Pale Horseman, which is the second book in the Last Kingdom series. I want to try to finish the series so I can get the books back to the library. So, The Pale Horseman. Then after The Pale Horseman, I want to get to The Two Lives of Lydia Bird, which is basically a separate timeline for, or like two separate timelines for a love story. One dealing with Lydia with her fiance passing away, and then one where he actually lived. So I can't wait to read this one. I love alternate timelines and stuff in books. Then after that, I want to read My Dark Vanessa, which is supposed to be in the title, a very dark and heavy book. All I know of it is basically it's a story of how a girl named Vanessa was groomed by her asshole teacher, and she becomes successful and stuff like this, and then she later has a revelation about what her teacher has done to her and how he's been doing it to other students, and he's not supposed to do that because of that fine line between teacher and student, and he went across the line, and it's basically the repercussions of how she thought how she was special and all of her success was because of this teacher, but it turns out that's not the case. So I heard many good things about this. I kind of gave you a crappy summary. I'm not good at summaries, but I can't wait to get into this one. And after that, I want to get into The Pride and the Prejudice by Jane Austen. I recently watched The Pride and Prejudice on YouTube. the version with Keira Knightley in it, and boy, I fell in love with the story. I watched the movie 3 times in a row. So, here you go. I want to read the source material, and can you just say that this is a beautiful cover? Oh, it's gorgeous. So, I want to try it out for myself. Oh, excuse me. And then lastly, the book that I want to get to is Love Unscripted by Owen Nicholls, which basically is a story that takes place during the Obama election or something, and how Ellie and Nick fall in love with each other, and I don't know much about it, but I read the back of it when I was at Target, when I got a gift card, and I just wanted to see how it was. So, that's it. Those are the 26 books that I want to read in the month of April, and I will keep you posted, and have a good one. Bye. Thank you.